What up, YouTube? I hope you're all doing well. In today's video, we are going to talk about the Fuji TCL X100 Mark II, which is one of two conversion lenses that are available for the X100 line of cameras. The other one is the WCL, which stands for wide conversion lens. And I've made a whole video about that. So if you're interested in that, feel free to check it out, linked in the description below. But this is about the TCL or teleconversion lens, which gives you the equivalent of a 50 millimeter field of view. But the most important question actually for most people is probably whether or not this will also actually give you more bokeh compared to the stock 23 millimeter that you get with the X100. So if you're interested in that, don't go away.
Just in case some of you are not familiar with the TCL or any of Fuji's conversion lenses for that matter, maybe you've just fallen asleep whilst watching something else and somehow you've ended up here. Allow me to explain what this preposterous looking thing actually does. For you see, this is not an actual lens, oh no. As the Fuji's X100 cameras come with a fixed 35mm equivalent lens only, and there's nothing you can do about it. These conversion lenses just bend the light in a way to give you a slightly different field of view. So with the wide conversion lens, you get something like a 28mm field of view, and with the TCL, you end up somewhere in the neighborhood of a 50mm equivalent. It's not true focal length though, so take this with a grain of salt, but it's nice to have them options. To mount it, just unscrew the ring from the stock lens to unveil that thread, and then simply proceed to screw on your conversion lens, simple as. With this just being a converter, there are no moving parts in this lens whatsoever. It's just a big chunk of aluminium and glass. It feels very solid overall though, so Fuji is back at it again with that build quality. One thing to keep in mind though, is that you won't be fitting your X100 into your jacket pocket anytime soon with this guy on. So in that regard, it completely ruins one of the main purposes of the X100 line, which is great image quality to size ratio. But we'll get back to that point later on. In terms of its functionality, it does what it's supposed to do. It gives you a slightly tighter field of view without sacrificing any resolution by using the built-in digital converter. Top marks for that. So in terms of overall image quality, I haven't done any scientific tests since I have better things to do with my spare time, but judging from my very amateur perspective, there seems to be some distortion, but unless you're planning to do architecture photography, you probably are not going to notice it either. At least I have never noticed it in my day-to-day use. The image quality overall also doesn't suffer. I feel the images with this lens come out slightly more contrasty and punchy than without it, which is a good thing in my book. But now for the most important part. The main reason for anyone to schlep around this preposterous looking thing would probably be an increase in the amount of bokeh you can get out of your shots, since bokeh is life. And yes, you do actually get slightly creamier and softer out of focus areas with this conversion lens, so it's easier to isolate your subject and make them portraits. But it's not worlds apart. Don't expect this to blow your mind. Any nifty 50 on any half-broken full-frame camera will probably still produce more bokeh than this guy will. But that's just the way it is. All of the above might sound rather negative and unappreciative, but overall, I thoroughly enjoy using this conversion lens. I actually use an X230 as an interchangeable lens camera if I really need options, but even though the X230 and the X100V are almost identical in many ways, technically speaking, I still prefer to shoot with my X100V whenever I can. And it's not even close, so having the option to get a bit more variety out of my X100 is much appreciated. Also, even though I totally shat on these converters earlier for making this camera bigger, they are still nowhere near as big as any of Fuji's higher prime lenses, and those aren't big by most standards either. So at the end of the day, this is still a very small setup and you can easily take your X100 and both conversion lenses stacked on top of each other, even in the smallest of camera bags. Also, you have to keep in mind that these conversion lenses are only about 250 bucks, so they are considerably cheaper than any of Fuji's prime lenses. Are they as good? No, probably not. But if they just get you a bit more enjoyment and usability out of your favorite camera, I think they are well worth the price tag. So that's my two cents on the subject. Let me know what you think in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching. Hit the thumbs up button if you like this video and consider subscribing if you want to see more. That's all I got for you today though. Until next time, take care.